Hi, hello, Hi, hello, kids and adults. It's me. I hope you are not panicking. I'm not panicking because this is a video COVID-19 part 5. For the spiritual one, try to understand what the number 5 means. In the case you still are on the panic, just don't panic. I try to get ready, and what I shouldn't do. I had plenty of notes, so I'm hardly breathing. But I needed to enlarge my huge brain. Sorry, my small brain, I needed to enlarge. Anyway, I think I need to make me, like, you know, COVID funny look. You know, like I usually was having during these videos. Excuse me. You do not want to know what I did. You know what I did. I did this. I don't know. I think I inherited this after my family. Okay, kids and adults. So, in this video, I am going to kind of tell you why you do not have to panic. Maybe you are too young, or maybe you are just a child. You are not panicking because COVID-19 is not really affecting you, because, as it was said, it's affecting usually vulnerable, already sick and older people. But, because you are younger, you may not know that we had on this world plenty of the epidemics caused by various viruses, bacteria, even funguses and different stuff, and humanity survived all. And most of all, I will start with this. I was looking at the very highly scientific informations which are proven, and the question was if any virus, bacteria, or if any pandemic, I was using the word names, you know, there are two terms, pandemic and epidemic. Epidemic means that the virus, bacteria, or the infectious disease, it spread only within its region. Let's say COVID would become only epidemic if it would spread only in Wuhan, China. But because it spread to more countries or worldwide, it became pandemic. Pandemics were the worst. I mean, even epidemics for the countries where they happened, they were not really nice. But the pandemics infected and affected all the world. And so, the scientific information, if any virus, bacteria, or any organisms or anything like this could wipe out all the humanities, no, it couldn't. Even if it would be the worst thing which we never have seen, it wouldn't happen because, you know, there is something like a rate of transmission. It's very important word or expression which you need to consider. Now I'm a little bit of advanced. I'm trying to be, but anyway, I needed to make notes and I must read them because it's too much for my brain to remember. Rate of transmission means that if you are just first infected person, on one many how many people you can spread it, yeah? And if the rate of transmission is, let's say, 2, it means that you will give it from your 100 million friends. Perhaps not Facebook friends, because Facebook friends do not count, they even do not exist. And sometimes they exist, but you know, you never meet them. Unless you would have some form of electronic virus, that you would just like look at someone's profile picture, or you would just like look at someone's video, or you would just like look inside my eyes directly. And you would get infected. I don't think this can really happen. You can just kind of transmit a little bit of the craziness, or you can deduct a little bit of the craziness. Let's say you can get a little bit of my craziness. But you can as well get the wisdom this way. So, we still need the technology, despite we have here around technology haters who are coming with different ideas that it is because of 5G. But we had even not close 5G back then. When I will start with the first documented plague or epidemic disease. But first I want to say that even if the virus would have rate of transmission very, very high, more higher than anything what we have seen, we need to consider then number of infectious people, number of contacts per person, then probability of infection. It means that even if we would have the worst virus, we still would have some people who by accident, or maybe not accident, but by nature creation, got the genes and they will not get sick, or they will get sick but they will not die. And then successible population, it means how many people can get so sick that they will die. And even if we would get the worst virus, the humanity cannot be wiped by virus. So you do not have to panic completely. Even if you would die, our message of the humans wouldn't die. And if you hate the humanity and you are expecting everyone, including you, will be killed by virus or by COVID-19, it's not going to happen. And perhaps usually would survive people who are living in very outside parts, maybe in the Nordic countries, or maybe perhaps the Nordic countries would be protected. But you know, we would have a complete disaster. We still could transfer some people inside the space and they would wait until it's okay on this planet. So you know, we are immune. We do not have to panic regarding this. And another thing is that we quite had many of these pandemics, especially one bubonic plague. It mutated and transferred and developed even the worst ever pandemic, Black Death, in 1346-1353. They said, the scientists, that it was some type of bubonic plague. But, you know, we had plenty of these things. Some of them were smaller, some of them are huge. Let's say HIV, it's killing millions of people every year. Then we still have Ebola, we still have cholera, we have lots of different things which are killing people, and especially hunger and wars, you know? I think that the humans cannot be really wiped by the virus, or like this is proven, this is not from my head, despite now I believe this, but, you know, this can repeat. I mean, the COVID-19 virus, it's not the last one. And definitely it's not the worst one, because it's affecting just the vulnerable and older people. But let's say in our history, we had the Spanish flu after First World War, 1918-1920s, which came in more waves, and this one was not nice. It was attacking the healthiest people between 20-40 years old, because it was working on some overreaction of your immune system. And I'm not going to the details, but the pandemic, just a second, in 1980s actually killed something between 50 and 100 million people. And it was a healthy young people. And if you would look deeper into this, I think COVID-19 is not even close to this problem. And the worst was Black Death in 1346-1353. But the first one was a plague of Athens in the 4th century before Christ. I think it was not the first one, but Athens were developed. Most of these pandemics started spreading in overcrowded, kind of civilized places. There was lots of people and the virus could spread. And as well with evolution or kind of traveling, you know? So today it's a simple. Spreading virus is just a question of one flight from somewhere to somewhere else, few people, and we have it everywhere. So I think we do not have to really panic that we would die all, but we can fairly panic that here is coming something much worse than is COVID-19, and something what will infect even more people, what maybe will kill much higher percentage of the people and the dead, and as well the all the progress of the illness will be much worse. So what I would say is that perhaps, I need to say something more about this Black Death. So Black Death wiped around 33% of all European population. And in some countries it was so high as 70 and 75 person of the European population. The dead people were even not counted finally, because there was not time to count them. Mm-hmm. As well, we had a smallpox. We had many, yeah. I mentioned here just a few of them. But we do not have to panic or to become like really crazy, because you know, from Black Death, actually, lots of people started to be yearning more, because so huge amount of the European population died that people had to be paid better, the few who were left, and they had to work. And then actually from the very, very poor people, some people could become land owners and could become richer. And another thing is as well, it helped with all the climate and global warming and everything. So, you know, maybe the nature actually knows exactly what the nature is doing. And it's up to us. You know, it's like this evolution of the consciousness. It's up to humans that we will stop doing the bad stuff, you know? We do not have to spend so much money for armies and killing each other. As you see, virus will do it well. Even from the Spanish flu, it died more people than in the world wars. So, you know, like, but it's a stupid, you know, we do not have to kill each other, really. We are too many, we as well do not have to multiply such madly as we are still doing. But instead spending our money on the buying guns and similar nonsense, then putting them to damaging all the nature, and then trying to kind of do really stupid things, you know? I love art, but even art, it's sometimes so stupid. I mean, perhaps I'm art and I'm stupid art as well, but at least I'm trying to be funny. But, you know, if we evolve like humanity, I think we will do better. And then we need to evolve everyone on our level, you know? If you will do some little tiny good thing every day, maybe those viruses will kind of run away from you. I mean, this is perhaps a stupid ideology. It's not that, scientists would say that this is nonsense. But you know what? Our world will become a little bit of a better world. So, kids and adults, I hope that my next video will be about something else. But I still want to show you one more type of chilies. I think there is a plenty of type of chilies. But another type of chilies, which will definitely kill lots of viruses, bacteria, funguses and everything like this. But I will show you this in my next video. And hopefully, in my next video, I won't be on the black. And we still will have COVID-19 because it's already damaging all my other work. So much stuff is cancelled, you know. Government as well needs to rethink this, because if we will come or fall inside the recession, depression, inflation, deflation, hyperinflation, and there is many, then not just the old and already sick people will be dying, but everyone will be dying without food, including me, and all the economy will be in ruins. So I think for now, for battling this virus, we need to concentrate on putting our economy up, and then we need to concentrate on trying to prevent and think how to defeat the viruses. And as well, I think stacking people, huge amount of the people, inside closed spaces when they are sick, it's really a bad idea, because it's making sick the people even more, because they are debriefing it. And as well, the healthcare professionals, they are deadly sick. Yeah, this is wrong. But I don't know, really. I do not have the solution, but I hope I will see you on the different background soon. Like, share, comment, and see you, kids and adults. Bye.